fallen communities, to BECs, to communion in mission. Para iisang thread lang sila. Now let me give a bit of context on that before we go for Bible sharing groups. Ang pinakamahalagang tanong po sa atin this morning, sabi ko, dalawa pa natin input this morning, the Word of God and your own input. Ang pinakamahalagang tanong na sasagutin natin is, what does God want to say to the clergy community of San Pablo? What does God want to say to the clergy community of San Pablo? So yung una po, doon sa Bible sharing, looking at the life, the challenges of the in communion, in mission of the Christian communities, how do they dialogue with us? O sa ating sariling issues and challenges as clergy community. So from Bible sharing po, we will take a break. By 11 o'clock, we will go to what we call the Council of Jerusalem. It will be a symbolic, ano ba yan? Symbolic living out ng ating Eucharistic celebration. Alam niyo mo po yung Council of Jerusalem, ano ba? Sa Acts 15, napakahalaga ang nangyari dyan. Kaya siguro tayo yung simbahan ngayon, katoliko, kristyano, sa panahon natin ngayon dahil dyan sa nangyari sa Acts 15. So, nung unang panahon po, alam kong alam nyo, yung issues ng Christian communities, especially ng mga bago communities, they come together in a council and they decide, bring out the issues, and clarify their stand. So, dito po sa after ng Bible sharing nyo, you will be put in clusters doon tayo mag-misa, a la Council of Jerusalem. Doon sa misa na yon, sa council na yon, katulad na nangyari sa council 2,000 years ago in Acts 15, they brought out their issues. At itong misa na to, we hope to answer that question, what does God want to say to the clergy of San Pablo? So yun ang ating misa. In a little while po, Georgie will prepare you for this. From Bible sharing to Council of Jerusalem. So, nakita po natin medyo may konting change po schedule. Pakinote na lang po. In the afternoon po, Father Mark shares with us, saan ba nagagaling authority of the leader? And we'd like to take that po from the experience of the Pauline communities, lalo na yung Council of Jerusalem. Leadership act kasi. And if you use that, leadership ang hinihingi nito. Saan galing ang authority ng leader na ito? So that will be this afternoon's talk po. And then at 4:30 to 5:30, ang inyong Blessed Sacrament Adoration, we try to write the questions in a bigger way para it can be part of your silent reflection. And then in the afternoon po is the Sacrament of Communion. Nakalagay sa schedule no? 6 to 7, pero talaga po malaki tayo. We were following this from Manila clergy, mas malaki po rin po. So we request po kung pwedeng 5:45 to 7:30. The Sacrament of Reconciliation po will be celebrated in a different way, tawag namin Sacrament of Common Home. It is a penitential rite led by Father Mark. It's a different way of celebrating. It has been evaluated po very well by different clergy groups. I hope it will be a meaningful experience for you also. But of course, you can still have your one-on-one reunion, the way you would do it or approach it. You'll have a chance to do that, of course. But we invite all sana to participate in this penitential rite as a community. Okay po ba yung changes ng schedule? Can you note it down po? Pasensya na po ah, mayroon lang mga ibang galaw itong araw na ito. And tomorrow po, we'll go back to the same schedule. Ang konting change lang po is a bit late sa merienda this morning and a bit late sa dinner mamaya. Collection, Pero para to prepare us spiritually and emotionally to enter into this gospel sharing. Some sources po that I used, yung house churches po we've heard of that. Ano? Kung nagbabasa tayo, especially ng Pauline epistles, makikita natin yung salitang house churches. Sila po yung pag sinabi natin early Christian communities, we're actually referring to house churches. So yung mga Romans, Corinthians, etc. were house churches. So they were early converts po. No? Gentile Christians, early converts, and they gathered in private houses. Madalas natin makita yan, ano? The assembly, the kahal, no? Those who are called, gathering in the house of. So sa Romans 16:3-5, Paul says, Greet Prisca and Aquila, siguro sila yung mayari ng bahay, who work with me in Christ Jesus, greet also the church in their house. So talagang iglesia ang ginagamit, talaga, the gathered people, the old people, iglesia. Ito naman po sa Philemon, to Philemon, our dear friend and co-worker, to Ophia, our sister, to Archippus, our fellow soldier, and to the church in their house. Romans, Gaius, who is also to me and to the whole church, greets you. So, nasaan yung whole church? No? Parang nakagather sila doon sa isang bahay. Pero po, bakit po ba yung ginagawa ng mga disciples, apostles, no, at that time, pagkamatay ni Jesus, ang uso ng kolegya, no? Fellowships, professional fellowships. Pero ba't nila ginamit ang house churches? Maybe because that's what they learned from Jesus. No, kaya pagkamatay ni Jesus, the same style ang ginawa nila. Alam ko po, you're aware that when you look at the scriptures, parating si Jesus nasa bahay, o nasa village, or nasa town. Some examples lang po. May idea po ba kayo how many times was he in houses, villages or towns? In terms of percentages, compared to how many times was he in the temple or synagogue? Minsan po, when we're doing a program for defining what Christian formation is, binalikan namin yung Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, tapos nilista namin isa-isa kung nasaan si Jesus. Masarap din pong balikan eh. No? How many times was he in a worship place like a temple or synagogue in the Synoptic Gospels? And how many times was he outside? Houses, villages, towns, lakes, trees, mountains, etc. May guess po kayo? 88% po he was outside. No? So if you round it off, that means 90%. So, bilangin niyo po isa-isa, binilangan namin isa-isa. So lahat ng kanyang formation, evangelization, was really outside. Okay. And kaya siguro sabi ni Pope Francis, we are periphery bound. Tayo ay papunta sa labas, hindi sa loob. At sabi niya, our shoes should be muddy. So, mas madalas po siya sa labas, sa kanyang evangelization work, ministry work. So, kaya siguro yung mga apostles, ganun din. Nagbahay-bahay din sila kasi sinusundan nila yung master niya. Post-Easter po, this is a very interesting story. You're so familiar with this. You've read this po so many times. When Peter po, napakawalan sa prison, miraculously, he knew where he had to go. He knew where the church was gathering. Hindi po ba? Mga tingnan niyo po, story na ito. No? So after siya mapakawalan, he went to the house of Mary, the mother of John, where many people had gathered and were praying. So may particular bahay siya na pinuntahan. He knew they were there. After that po, yung another yellow line, tell James and the brothers about this, he said this, and then he left for another place. He knew where the prisoners were gathered. Siyempre, yung upper room, alam din natin. Alam din ako saan sila nag-gather. Post-Easter. So the plurality of house churches in Jerusalem, we saw them growing rapidly. No? Yun talaga yung way of being church. No? Tinanggal po yung growing ng house churches, palagay ko, alam nyo na yun, nakita nyo na yun, dami yung mga nag-retreat sa Jerusalem last year. So, two or three households gathered together and we call it a house church. Noong mga umpisang araw ng early Christianity, yung mga bahay po noon, malalaki. No? Pero most probably, they gathered in the homes of the richer members, the more affluent members of the Christian community. So most probably po, the host no, of that household becomes the leader of the household. Alam natin, yung Roman households, parang, nakita niyo siguro yun, no? Para siyang, parang mga business households. Sa harapan, may shop, tapos paloob, may office, pagkatapos may malaking garden, tapos may dining place, tapos may kitchen, etc. Bedrooms, malaki po talaga. So, ibig sabihin ng Roman household, hindi lang yung nuclear family, pero atunod din yung iba't ibang tao, the slaves, the free persons, may mga tradespeople, may businessmen, may hard workers. O, iba-ibang grupo ng tao. Siyempre, may babae, may lalaki, may bata. So sabi ko po kanina, most probably yung head ng household, eh yung pater familia, the head of the family. Pero at least we hear of one household na mag-asawa, ang head, at saka babae. Ayan po yung grupo. Are gathered in my name. Baka po most probably they meant two or three households. No? Kasi doon nag-gather or nag-worship yung unang Christian communities. Siguro po with this, para makikita na natin, ganun yung pinag-umpisahan ng mga BGCs natin. And going back to that traditional setup ng simbahan. So pag sinabing house church, nag-gather sila on a regular basis. At meron silang community life, at meron silang life of mission. No, doon sa community life na yon, may worship, may teaching, may fellowship, no? And have some things to organize themselves. So makikita natin po sa mga kwentong iyan sa Acts, yung sinabi ko, the healing of the sick, the caring for the poor and the needy, aside from the fellowship, breaking of the bread, or worship. No? So itong mga babasahin natin communities, hindi lang siya Bible text. No? When we read it now, para lang siyang Bible text and what that inspired us, a story from a long time ago. Pero there was a life happening there. Kaya nga po, it's good to look back at that life. Eh. Kumusta ba yung kanilang communion in mission? No? Yan ang gusto natin gamitin ngayon. No? Hanggang first thing tomorrow morning. No? Communion in mission of early Christian communities. How was their life? No? And you want to enter this life. Ilang implications lang po. No? Kaya house churches, most probably, it was the simplest way to have Christian presence, no? In a particular setting. No? So maganda pong makita na it was the simple or the easiest way na mayroon Christian presence, no? In a very local setting. And in everyday life. Yun po siguro yung muna. Ikalawa po, dahil house churches, inbuilt yung intimacy. Kasi ang kasya lang doon sa place nila where they can gather, eh 20 to 40 persons maximum. So parang built in yung intimacy. So yung sense ng house churches, daily presence, daily Christian presence in a home setting, presence that is intimate, na mayroon personal relationships. Alam naman po natin that the house can actually build up a person or destroy a person. So napakahalaga ng concept ng house. Alam naman po natin na building up a good family also means building up a good society. Kaya parang yun, dating naman yun, bakit ba house churches eh? Palagay ko po, pinili yun kasi the early church wants to plant itself doon sa very space where generations are formed and shaped. So, hindi lang in a parish building or in a fellowship, professional fellowship, like a kolegya, pero in houses. Kasi po, that's where generations are shaped. In a daily, intimate setting. So, napakagandang approach yung naisip nila at the start of our church, Christian church. Moreover po, dahil nag-household sila compared to a professional kolegya, na-reach nila ang all social ranks. Bata matanda, slaves, freedmen, tradespeople, businessmen, oh, na-reach po nila din, reach across the social strata. So maganda rin yung kanilang style, no? If they had chosen the fellowships or the collegia, the professional groups, isang grupo lang ang nag-reach niya. When they choose the households, they come across all social strata. So, yung Christian presence, hindi lang in a daily setting, pero in a way that reaches all levels of society. Tsaka po all generations. No? Andun yung mga bata. So, alam naman po natin yung significance ito nung pag sinabing ang simbahan ay pamilya, it's a good way po to check yung ating pagkasimbahan. From the biggest level, diocese, to the smallest level, the parish, the church groups, the BECs, pamilya po kaya yung sense. Napakahalaga yung concept na yun, the household of God. So, napansin po natin, yung bahay, hindi lang naging place for worship and fellowship, naging base din for mission. No, kasi dyan yung ang dami-dami kwento, yung healing ni Jesus nangyayari sa mga bahay-bahay. So hindi lang community assembly, hindi lang community formation and fellowship, mission din. So maganda, matandaan lang ito pag binabalikan natin yung early Christian communities. Last point na lang po, only in the house churches was it possible to have a specific Christian worship that later developed into the Eucharist. Yung Eucharistic celebration natin, ang pinag-umpisahan niya yung house churches. It was not possible po in the temple, kasi they were doing Jewish practices. It was not possible in the synagogue, kasi breaking of the bread and fellowship. The Eucharistic celebration was only made possible dahil doon sa house church structure. So yung house churches po was the one that made it possible to have a specific Christian worship that later developed into a Eucharistic celebration. So napakahalagang regalo po yan ng house churches natin. It's a good question to ask. Yung atin ba pag-ipag-link po yung house churches and Eucharistic celebrations? Yung atin po bang Eucharistic celebration ay may sense ng family. No, kasi sobrang link ng dalawa, long time ago. Yung Eucharistic celebration were there in the house churches. So pag tingnan mo Eucharistic celebration natin, meron ba siyang sense ng family? O meron pang ugnayan ang house churches or BECs sa mga Eucharistic celebration in the center? Baka meron ding link doon o may gap na nawawala o may missing gap. Ano, yung ugnayan ng house churches, local neighborhoods, neighborhood churches, to the Eucharistic celebration in the center. No, baka namin doon yung gap. Kasi dati palitado. No? So in this way po, it is nice to go back. Nice to go back po, dun sa early Christian communities or house churches as we call them. Ano yung naging buhay nila? Ano yung naging link nila sa mga BEC ngayon? At paano nila tayo china-challenge, no, at this time. So now po, we somehow enter this life, Corinthians, Romans, Philippians, Ephesians, let's enter this life po, knowing that this is not just an inspired text, but there was a whole life happening in these communities. And we allow the life of the Christian communities to talk to us as a clergy community. Tignan natin yung challenges nila in communion and mission and allow their stories to challenge us also. And bring out another issues and challenges ng San Pablo clergy community when it comes to communion and mission. Jody prepares us for this Bible sharing diretso sa Council of Jerusalem, Eucharistic celebration.
So as Stella po mentioned, we will be divided into five Christian communities. Two tables will be assigned one particular community. So, halimbawa po, these two tables will be together, the two tables together, reflecting on one particular Christian community. Pag nagkita-kita po kayo, una po, you can go anywhere. Your small group of two tables can go anywhere. You can stay here, you can stay outside, yung mga prayer rooms po dyan sa labas. May mga prayer rooms din po dun sa ating tulugan, in the second floor, there's a chapel there. So anywhere po you can go to have your Bible sharing. Once you come together po, kindly assign someone to just facilitate the Bible sharing. Lahat naman po nandito. The instructions will be here. You just have to follow the steps, no? And then the readings po that you will be needing, nasa likod naman po ng guide niyo. So you don't need to bring a Bible kasi nasa likod naman po yung mga readings. Ang suggestion lang po namin, once you get a hold of this copy and you start your Bible share, please po, do not skip a step. Sundan lang po natin yung guide and we follow it until the last step. And then before, after po nung mag-sharing in your small group, before going into a break, i-divide nyo na po yung grupo nyo into three groups. So halimbawa po, itong dalawang grupo, mag-count off lang po kayo 1, 2, 3 kasi that will be your representative to the three clusters. So that means that in one cluster, there is a representative from the Corinth community, from the Roman community, from the Colossae community, from the Philippi community, and from the Ephesus community. So ganun po yung mangyayari. After ng break, didiretso na po tayo sa tatlong clusters. Each cluster will be represented by the different communities na meron po tayo dito. The clusters po, the three clusters, will be here in the prayer room just outside our hall. Meron pong prayer room dyan. One will be in the main chapel. Sa yellow building tsaka sa green building kung saan po tayo natutulog. Sa second floor po kasi ng mga building na yon, may chapel. So one will be here, one will be in the yellow building chapel, the other one in the green building chapel, sa second floor po yun. So we don't have to meet here after the break. After po ng break, yung mga representatives ng grupo po ninyo pupunta na kagad doon sa mga clusters. And in the cluster, we will celebrate the Eucharistic celebration. Again po, we will have to ask one of you in that cluster to celebrate the Eucharistic celebration, to be the main celebrant. Meron po bang in-assign?
Meron.
Okay. So sila po yung mag-assign. And then, there is no need po for a homily since the homily will come from you, from the sharing of the different communities. How you have reflected on it and how you have resonated with the experiences of the early Christian community. So ganun po yung mangyayari. Instead of the homily, ang homily po is actually the sharing of each Christian community on how they have reflected on the community that they were assigned. And then the usual flow po of the Mass. Ganun lang po. The usual flow of the Mass, instead for the homily, to be the sharing of the different groups. Okay po? Meron po bang tanong? Yung clustering po, yung pag nakita-kita po kayo, kayo na po ang mag-divide among yourself kung saan pupunta. Opo. Alin po?
Cluster 1.
Ang 1 po nandito, sa likod, ang 2 sa yellow building, yung kung saan po tayo natutulog, ang 3 ay doon sa green building, all in the second floor. Okay po? Sige. I-distribute ko na po yung mga Christian community. Again, you can meet po here, you can meet outside, you can find a place where you can have your Bible sharing. Okay po?
Rome.